But generally speaking, over recent years, and even with, and this is my point, the introduction of tapering by the Fed and a lot of the dialogue about where the Fed is going from here, volatility has decreased significantly in recent years. And on balance, we think the U.S. economy is pulling in the right direction and animal spirits, as we say, beginning to take hold, so we would expect things to continue to improve from here. So let's talk about the wealth management industry today, my second topic. Headline here, still large and vibrant. We have had a contraction in registered reps over the last 10 years. I was looking at one source for this data. There were 340,000-ish registered representatives in 2003-04, 303,000 or so today, so a decline there. But the assets that these financial advisors are managing on behalf of their clients, assisting their clients with, have grown from $9 trillion in 2008 during the crisis to $13.4 trillion at the end of 2013. This is still a business that investors like, analysts, the market. When they're looking at a business like wealth management, they see the steady predictability of earnings, the client nature of the business, the financial advisors working closely with clients, relatively low capital intensive, so the premium the market puts on this business, and you can look at asset management firms, there are a few publicly traded wealth management firms, trust banks. The market continues to reward companies and businesses like wealth management with a higher earnings multiple.